Hey everybody, I am Aman and today I am going to review the book Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. What I am holding right now is actually the combined series of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory and another book, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator. This book is available in two pieces as well. The book is written by one of my favorite authors, Roald Dahl. It is beautifully illustrated by Quentin Blake. The book has been adapted into two movies. I feel the book is way more fun and interesting than the movie. It stimulates your imagination and takes you to their world. The story is about the adventures of Charlie Bucket inside Mr. Willy Wonka's mysterious and magical chocolate factory. Charlie is 11 years old. He lives in a small house with his parents and four grandparents. They are very poor. He loves chocolate a lot, but he can only afford to have one every year on his birthday. One day, Charlie's grandpa Joe tells him about Mr. Willy Wonka and all the wonderful sweets he makes. So, chocolate companies got jealous and sent spies to steal his secret recipes. So, Wonka stopped allowing visitors to his factory. One day, Wonka announces that he has invited five lucky children to come on a tour. He hides five golden tickets and five bars of chocolate. The first four golden tickets are found by greedy Augustus, spoiled Veruca, chewing gum addicted Violet, and TV addict Mike TV. Luckily, Charlie finds a 50 pence coin buried in the snow. He buys two Wonka bars and miraculously finds the last golden ticket in the second bar. The ticket says that he can bring one or two family members with him, and Grandpa Joe happily agrees to go with them. Wonka welcomes the five children and their parents inside the factory. It is a wonderland in there. Everything is edible. Chocolate waterfalls, chocolate river with a giant boat made of sweets, marshmallow bushes, grass made of minty sugar. Ah, it's so mouth-watering. I would love to go to such a wonderful factory. Wonka says that there is enough hot chocolate in the river to fill up every single bathtub and swimming pool in the whole country. They also meet the Oompa Loompas, a race of little people who help him operate the factory. During the tour, the four children give in to their impulse and are rejected in funny ways. Augustus drinks from the chocolate river and what happens to him is fun real. Violet snatches a full coarse gum which is about to be sent to the testing room. Her body gets bigger and bigger and she starts turning purple in the skin. What happens to her is very funny. Veruca wants a squirrel and tries to get one. She is so greedy. I'll quote her words. She says to her parents, "Mommy, I want a trained squirrel. All I've got at home is two dogs and four cats and two parakeets and three canaries and a green parrot and a turtle and a bowl of goldfish and a silly old hamster. I want a squirrel." After that, Charlie and Mike get in the elevator. It goes up and down and left and right and front and back. In fact, it goes to every room in the factory, says Mr. Wonka. Then Mike gets to select a room. Obviously, since he's such a TV addict, he chooses the television room. It is interesting to read what happens to him and Charlie there. There's a surprise waiting for you at the end of the book too. The book is very interesting and fun. It's so descriptive that you feel as if you are part of the tour too. You will get totally engrossed while reading this book. I will also do a video on the sequel of this book, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator. This is one of my most favorite fantasy books and I hope you will like it too. Thanks for watching. Bye. Please like, subscribe and click on the bell icon.